Okay, so welcome back again. Now, in the session, we are going to have a mental talk by Dida Mozchukur, and she's going to explain how to cope with stress during the conference and public, and she'll give you us public speaking tips. The session will be really beneficial, not only for EMEAN conferences, also for your career. Let me introduce herself to you. Dida Mozchukur is an 18-year-old first-year student of economics in Boğaziçi University. She has been attending EMEAN conferences since 2015. Her EMEAN journey started in the Politics and Diplomacy Club of TED Ankara College, and now she's a member of Boğaziçi EMEAN Club. She has attended various domestic and international conferences as a delegate, chairperson, and academic team member. She had the chance of being in the organization team of both TEDMUN and BoğaziçiMUN. Besides EMEAN, she also regularly attends Turkish and English debate tournaments. So, Dida Mozchukur, stage is yours.
Okay, I'll share my screen. Wait a second. Okay, I guess it's okay right now. So, thanks for being here, first of all. And I will be starting this presentation with telling you the story of my very first conference. Well, my first conference was JEM UNESCO 2015, and the topic was Ukraine and Russia, the crisis between them. And as an eighth grader, I literally knew nothing about the topic. And like while trying to give a public speech, I felt like everybody was looking at me, and I didn't know what to be saying and what to be doing. And when I went home, I started crying because I thought I would never be able to make any friends, and I would never be actually successful in Model United Nations. But actually, as I'm now here delivering you this presentation, it looks like even if I cried, I managed to come to some point. So I will be sharing my experience and some tips with you to be successful and to make you feel better in Model United Nations. So when I think about why do we get excited in a Model United Nations conferences, I see four main points. The first one is that we are in a whole new environment and that there are not any familiar faces, we don't have any friends, and we don't know what exactly we are going to do. And also we might feel like we are not knowledgeable enough about the topic that we have at hand. We are afraid of being judged if we say something wrong, and we are not sure if what we know is right or not. Also, we are actually afraid what will the people be thinking about us if we make any mistakes or if we have any kind of problematic points in our speeches. And the last point is that we might get the perception that the people, the others, are way better than us in their English level, in their knowledge level, with their and also with their experience. And in this presentation, I will show you that actually these four points are all rebuttable and that they are not valid if you have proper research. So, starting with the first one, since we might be getting excited because we don't have any friends and no familiar faces in Model United Nations, but actually, Model United Nations is the best place for you to get some friends. But first of all, you're going probably going with your own school to the conference, so you will have some familiar faces. And also, you can use a coffee breaks or social events or the lobbying time to get to know some people, because those people are not very different from you. They are just from a different city or from a different high school. And also, as you get to know people, the familiar faces that you see in conferences and the number of them will be increasing, and you will be feeling better as you will be feeling like you're talking with your friends. Also, for the second point, having proper research is the most important thing that you can do in Model United Nations, because like when you're speaking, you might be thinking that what I'm saying is wrong, or I don't know enough, I don't have any statistics, and they know better than me. But if you have proper research, these kinds of concerns will not be valid anymore. And like if you're a perfectionist, the research part of Model United Nations can be very, very complicated, because like when you are having your research, there are like 75 pages that are open, and you had found a report of 200 pages, and you're trying to read all of them, and there are 2 days to the conference, and it's a total catastrophe. I know that. So when you're trying to make your research, don't be a perfectionist. The optimal point for research that you have is when you're able to have a casual conversation about the topic at hand with your family or friends. Like You have your own ideas and you know the background of the topic and you can convey these ideas to the other people in a casual conversation. We'll focus on the cause and effects of the topic at hand, and also while having a research to have these casual conversations, do not focus on academic articles. Instead, you can use YouTube videos or use blog articles to understand the topic better and have arguments for yourself. Research, like if you're going to take 2 points from this presentation of mine, one of them is that research is the most important thing to be confidently speaking in front of people. Also, the thing is that when we go to the stage, we are going about to deliver a speech, we feel like all of the people are looking at us and all of them are going to listen to us, and they will be judging what we are going to say. But in reality, 80% of the people that are present in the committee are only physically present in the committee. They are not listening to the debate. They are not listening to your speech. They are not listening to the chair. Think of yourself. You are never able to listen to each and every person that is delivering a speech in a Model United Nations conference. 80% of the committee, in reality, they are thinking about the lunch break, or they are thinking about their immune crush and stuff. So when you see all those faces that are looking at you, there's no reason for you to be getting excited, because they are actually not listening to you. And the fact that they are not listening to you is not about you. It's because they are probably getting bored in a two-hour session. So let's look at what the others are doing. We already said that 80% of the people are not listening to you. And the 16% or so are trying to get awards, and they are listening to everything. They have research, and these kind of delegates can be very intimidating and can be very tense for if you're a first timer or if you believe that you don't have any enough experience. And then the rest of them is the committee director and the academia. Starting with the committee director, you might have the perception that the academic team, the committee director, they are all so knowledgeable about the topic. They know everything, the details, and they will be judging every single speech that you make, every sentence that you make. But in reality, these academic people, these committee directors, do not exactly know the topic themselves as well. Because I have been a chair for tens of times. From what I observe, we also try to get a general view of the topic that we have, instead of focusing on the details. So even the committee directors, because they are simple students, do not know the topic very perfectly. Okay, never forget this. Also, these 16% delegates who are trying to get awards, who are rather physically dominant in the committee, let's look at those delegates. Okay. So this is my friend Ege, this is me as a chair, and this is my friend Khan, okay? When you go to a Model United Nations conference, you see these kind of people. Coming from a very good university, physically bigger than you, having really good speeches, having a strong knowledge about the topic, you're intimidated. I will never be good as these people. They are trying to get a voice and they are trying to achieve something. Oh my God, they are so good and so professional. We all get this perception of those people, especially coming from universities or high schools that we admire. These kind of committee directors might look like they are judging you and they are trying to find your fault, but in reality, these are all people like you and me. Let's look at all those people without their suits and without their fancy dresses and without in an immune environment. Okay. This is Ege, the guy that you saw in the last slide that was having a nice speech. He has a pink head and he's smiling with his friend. Or Khan is having a casual walk, and I have a photo with Johnny Bravo in here. So what is the message in here is that every person, every so professional person that you see in Model United Nations is actually person like you, just like you. The only difference that you have is that you are coming from different high schools and you're coming from different cities. I might be looking like very professional delivering orders as a committee director, but in my free time, I Photoshop stuff to my own photos, or I make toys like these. And every single person that you meet is like you. They have their friends, that they have their crushes, that they have the concerns about their academic things. So when you're intimidated by a person or by a speaker, by your chair, think of these kind of things that they are doing in their free time as a student without in the Model United Nations environment. It will make you feel really better, and it will be easier for you to befriend people that you meet in Model United Nations. Okay, also another important point is the number of experiences and how many conferences have you gone to. Like, we all ask each other how experienced we are. I think I've gone to more than 30 conferences, and I have observed something about experience and why is it not important. Well, this is the x-axis is the number of conferences that you attend to, and this is what you learn and what you get from. Like, in your first conference and in your first 5 conferences, you really learn something about United Nations, about public speaking, about your English skills, about meeting people. But after a while, actually, things that you get from attending a further conference is really, really low, because you are doing the same thing over and over again, delivering the rules, or looking at the rules of procedure, thinking about probably the same topics and seeing the same people all over and over again. So when someone says that, I have a 45 United Nations experience, well, please never forget that they are not different from a person who has 15 experiences or so. Like, after a while, attending American conferences becomes basic repetition, and especially if you're a chair, you learn nothing, because like artificial intelligence program could have easily done what a chair does in a Muslim United Nations conference. So please don't think that these chairs, this academia, organization, team, oh, they are so professional because they have so many experience. Well, because they don't. The additional conferences that we attend actually don't give that much of a thing to us, okay? Okay, so I believe now you have a proper idea about the audience that you're talking to in a Model United Nations conference. So let's look at how can we make a speech better and how can we deliver our message better to the people. Well, I have 3 parts for delivering a better speech. The first one is that listening to others. Like, if you don't listen to others, how can you give an answer to them? It would be not logical to do so. And the second part is to form your ideas about what you're going to be telling to people in your speech. And the third one, probably the most important part, is to prepare some notes and prepare a paper. Okay. If you are going to learn 2 things from this presentation, as I said before, the second thing is that is this part. In Model United Nations conferences or in a public speaking thing, like a debate or a presentation, never write a full speech of yours, because people will know that you're reading something, and if your speech will not be effective, people will be getting bored of listening to you. And also, while you're trying to write a speech, because you don't want to get excited while speaking, the committee will never wait for you. So the topic will change. But you will have a speech about the topic that was mentioned 30 minutes ago, and it will do no good actually for the debate. And also, you will never be able to listen to the other ideas and participate while you are writing something. So never ever write a full speech. Instead, you should be preparing some notes that you can understand. Like, this is a paper that I used in Boğaziçi EMEA 2020. My handwriting, the sentences, it is never understandable from an outsider viewer. But the thing is that I can understand what I'm going to say when I look at this paper. So what you should be doing is preparing these kinds of notes that you yourself can understand, but never thinking about the others, okay? Having some brief notes is a very, very important point for having a public speech, because like, when you're speaking, you forget what you were saying, and you just look at the committee like this. If you don't want to go through this, have some notes, and you look at this, you remember what you're doing, okay? This is very important. So also a few more points for a better speech in Model United Nations is to use mechanisms and to use cause and effect in your speeches. Like, when you're giving a speech, answer the question why. Why would it be like this? Why should we do this, or why shouldn't we do this? Because like, what I observe from Model United Nations is that we just use sentences which can be considered as slogans, like education is very important. We are condemning the nations with who have done this act. Okay, education is important. Okay, you are condemning, but why? I don't know, how are we going to be solving this issue then? Like, what is the point of this speech if you don't use any cause and effect and use whys in your speeches? Like, as it was mentioned, I also attend debate tournaments, and I believe why the debate can be better in developing ourselves is because we don't use why and cause and effect and mechanisms in Model United Nations while giving speeches. So if you try to do this, you will learn a lot more and you will be a better Model United Nations speaker as well. Never forget this as well. Also, your voice and your notation is also very important, because you should be emphasizing the important points that you make with your speech. If it's like you are reading something from what you have, nobody will be listening to you, because like, I could have read that by myself. Why are you here delivering a speech? That would be a question for me. And also, if you want to be looking more professional, you can give statistics and you can use formal official the names of formal official reports, because like as a chair or as a delegate, when you hear statistics or these kinds of reports mentioned, you think that the delegate has a nice research, they know something, so you are you become more willing to cooperate with them, you become more willing to listen to what they are saying. If you want to obtain some power in the committee, using statistics and these official reports, it always looks very professional. Also, another point that I've observed, although it's not in the slides, is that if you're trying to have a ideology or idea to be accepted in the committee, again, explain why it would be better than the other ideas or the other ideologies. Just using the name of the ideology or the idea that you have will not be very, very convincing for the other delegates. Okay, so never forget that you cannot become a better version of yourself without getting out of your comfort zone. Then, like, if you're going to attend a Model United Nations conference, you're spending money, time, effort, and all those stuff. So don't spend all of this money and time for just sitting in another school. So always try to make speeches, even if you don't believe in yourself, because after a while, you will start to see that you're improving and you are becoming a very, very good delegate. Like, you might be scared that your English is not good enough for having a speech, but if you don't speak and if you don't try to improve yourself, you will not improve yourself. So even if you think that you have some problematic points, try to speak, because nobody in a Model United Nations conference is in the position to be judging you or to be laughing at you, because we are all university or high school students. Nobody has a PhD in international relations or something like that. I hope they don't actually. So this is all my presentation. You can always contact me from my Instagram, or you can send me a mail, or I can also accept questions right now. Like, I have 3 minutes, but I can.
Yes, thank you for your presentation. So please feel free to write your questions. And there's one. I believe in that organizing an MUN is about networking. What do you suggest for networking to a shy delegate?
That's a very nice question. Well, what I observe is that for networking, people use social events and also the out of MUN places, because they really become friends with those people. Like, when you see all those people that are in suits and all in pretty dresses, it might be a bit problematic to go and talk with them. But it is actually not, because everybody is actually waiting for you to come and talk with them, to become friends with them. So I don't think that it's a problematic thing to be going and talking with people, because when you start to talk, you won't be talking about Model United Nations or international relations. You will be talking about your pets or your hobbies or what you like as music or what accounts that you follow on Instagram. So it is not a problematic thing to be going and talking with people. People are waiting for you to be talking with them. It's not problematic. Just go talk with them, I would say.
Yes. Are there any more questions? Okay. So do not hesitate to write, or you can raise your hand and you can speak right now.
I think there aren't any questions. Okay. You can send me a mail if you remember another thing. Okay. I would be more than happy to help.
Okay. So thank you very much for your presentation. So see you at the next session at 12 p.m.
Thank you.